Yeah, I make sure to look it up as far as I possibly could.
Thank you. It's like, your headphones are just okay.
Nobody on the street.
I don't know how much. It takes me.
Thank you. Chen Fei Kuan.
Thank you.
home to DJ Q on the ones and twos right now. We got big fans this season. And I'm your host, DT the Artist. Shout out to everybody on the side.
I can't stop the.
I know it's cold, but we're gonna warm up the soul.
I can't stop
the. Can't stop it. Hey,
Thank you. today is about windshield is about minus 13 outside, so I don't think so I can go out, which is good because I can do correction on a board number 2 with the puzzles, where I have a situation now like this. If we count numbers from 0 to 1, we see that 0 is, in order to come to number 1, it has to jump over number 9, which is not good. That is why I'm going to move 0 over here on position of C, which is now C. And the C I'm going to move on position on number 8. And number 8 I'm going to move on position of 0. So 0 goes here, C goes here, 8 goes here. Now when I count from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 is here, right? It comes from here, here. 8, 9. So I'm not jumping like here. 8, jump over 0 to 9. And that is why I have to do this correction. And when I finish, I'll show you how it looks like. Here we see at the top left corner, 16 cubes standing on their own squares, top right corners. At the top right corner, we see 16 cubes standing on their own squares, bottom right corners. Here we see at the bottom right corner, 16 cubes standing on their own squares at the 16 bottom left corners. Here we see at the bottom left corner, 16 cubes standing on their own 16 squares, top left corners. If we turn board 90 degrees and look top left corner where the 16 cubes are standing, we see that they are all standing at the top right corner. If we look at the top right group of 16, we see that they are all standing and at their bottom right corner. If we look group of 16 at bottom right corner, we see that they are all standing on their 16 squares bottom left corners. If we look the group at the bottom left corner, we see that all 16 are standing on their top left corner. If we turn another 90 degree and look where is the top left corner standing, 16 cubes are, we see, standing at their squares top right corner. If we look at top right group, we see it's standing at the bottom right corner. If we look at the bottom right group, we see that all 16 are standing on their squares bottom left corners. If we look at bottom left group, then we see that they are all 16 standing on their squares top left corner. And if we turn the last 90 degree and check now. Where is top left group standing? And there we can see that they are all standing at the top, their own square's top right corners. If we look top right group, we see they're all 16 are standing at the bottom right corners. And we see here, bottom right group, they're all 16 standing at their bottom left corners. And if we look the bottom left group, we see that they're all 16 standing on their own squares, top left corners. So, this is the story. From any side we look, we see the same thing. Right? Anyhow we look, we see the same thing. That is to say, if there are four people sitting or standing on four sides around the board, and you ask each of them, what do you see at the top left corner? They will all say they see the same thing. But if you ask them, where is your blue sun piece, they will all show in different groups their piece. What a fun.
Thank you. getting drunk on the reg, fucking good times on the reg, yachts on the reg, sex on the reg.
Okay, I got it, yeah.
Basically all the shit that most men fantasize about. I got the glory, I get the fame, the money, the jewels, the cash, the knowledge.
Right.
Getting drunk on the reg, good times on the reg, yachts on the reg, sex on the reg, drunk on the reg, good times on the reg.
I'm drunk so much now, sober's in the buzz. Always good times, don't care about what you does. Group sets, the poison out, use drugs. Victim under peer pressure like a group hug. I don't do speed as it makes me paranoid. I like to fuck free, so I steer clear of steroids. Park in the back, in the business up front. And I'm in the cash, and the bitches I've done. Cause I'm ballin' on pain, and I hit the showers. How to run him, and they call me Powers. And these cowards, gonna swing and miss. I'm the captain on my ship, sipping Chris. And with moves like this, we make it win. Get paid, get laid on a regular day. Ahead of the game, a beastman ready to play. I stack my name, blazing up ahead of these lanes. Yeah,
drunk on the red.
Dumb alcohol.
Good times on the red. Yachts on the red. Sex on the red. Drunk on the red.
Dumb alcohol.
Good times on the red. Yachts on the red. Sex on the red.
Drunk on the red. I'm an alcoholic. Smoke the chronic, rap on the rank, so my heart's up on it. But it's a dope sound, so I got stuff on it in rap. White T's and MVP, born to be a superstar like Candy P. And that's why most people envy me. Probably just pissed off, same friends with me. Me on yachts on the rank, trips on the rank, chicks with ice kiss to play whip on the rank. So you know it's always good times on the rank. Man, a party all night until we drain the kegs. And you know I throw it down like LeBron when he comes. Forget the bathroom, I'm in the club doing key marks. At the house party, lines bigger than ski jumps. The bitch in a roller slip, think it's a tree trunk.
Drunk on the rig,
dumb alcohol.
Good times on the rig, yachts on the rig, sex on the rig. Drunk on the rig,
dumb alcohol.
Good times on the rig, yachts on the rig, sex on the rig.
Every day, all day, drinking roll with your chicks, something like the ball, play the hell with what y'all say. That's how I do, regularly, but fucking hoes all guys, get my specialty, especially on S&P, that's what team, and we all hold in, growing up, ecstasy, we the best to be, and do it since Kenny, my team stay drunk, yeah, ruined all, Kenny, he slips the leg, how he does it on the regular, slip and blow like my last name, basketball, barely all pitch around like rockets, busting mad heads, knocking eyes out sockets, fat pockets, dollar bills, I got jockeys. Should get out on the bill. I drop it on the reel, on the rex. I'm a legend. You might as well call me Kenny Bowles the second.
Drunk on the reg,
dumb alcohol.
Good times on the reg, yachts on the reg, sex on the reg. Drunk on the reg,
dumb alcohol.
Good times on the reg, yachts on the reg, sex on the reg.
I'm not going anywhere today for sure. Look at this. Where would I go? You understand? Everybody understands this. On all odd cubes, odd values are marked with a dot at the top left corner of the image. So kings also got missing dots, missing in previous video. On a power chess pieces and pawns as well. So actually only kings was missing, but it was missing on each of the cubes, because each odd cubes has a king on it, right? So missing dot is now on each odd cubes, on each odd cubes. And we have it here, and we have it here. We have it here. And we have it here, right? So this is, and it's done in all four groups. So now all odd values on odd cubes are marked with a dot at the top left corner. Even values don't have anything on any size, any side marked on. Only odd cubes have a mark dot. Only their odd values have dot at top left corner. Even values don't have any dots. So look at odd cubes, odd values, even value, odd value, odd value. Odd value, even value. But it, pawns doesn't play in this game of chess for four players. Instead of pawns, we use smaller images, identical to power pieces, to mark if the image is a bishop. Without that, it will belong to bishop without that. If it is a rook without that, his pawn would be rook, small rook without that, right? And that's all, I hope so, very clear. So that is it. I marked final step with the kings. So all cubes are marked. Now we can proceed in next video with a story about the color-coded chess for four players. If we look at groups and how the cubes are positioned inside the groups, then this group here, I don't think so, I have to explain which colors they are, right? Let me tell you quick explanation about these cubes. There are 64 cubes. They are absolutely identical on all six sides, except their size, and 32 of them have dots on them, on their odd values.
So look at
this is the story. Odd value cubes have odd value on them. Even value cubes have no odd value on them. Odd values are those with the dots. So let me tell you one thing. As I said, there are 64 identical cubes. They're identical cubes, right? On all six sides. You see, this one is totally identical. There are six images on them. On each of them, there are only six images. The difference between them is 32 of them are smaller, and they represent pawns, and 32 are power chess pieces. The other difference is there are odd cubes and even cubes. Odd cubes have dots on them of their odd values. Even cubes, they don't have on them any dots. They have odd value on them, but they don't have no dots on them. So they could be recognized as even cubes, right?
Very clear.
Because there are two horses. One has dots, one doesn't. There are two rooks. One has dots and one doesn't. There are two rooks. One has dots and one doesn't. So you see, this is the whole story.
In next video, with a story about the color-coded chess for four players.
So one rook has dot and the other has not. Horse, one without dot, one with dot. And same things with the pawns. And pawns are absolutely identical, right?
Table here.
As these. As you can see, they're absolutely identical. Okay, let me see. I look at the cube, I should look at the display.
On the top.
Anyway, here, they are identical, you see?
64.
They are absolutely identical.
Chess cubes.
In every way.
Over here.
Except the size.
So it is, you see, important to know how you read color combinations.
Right? And
so let's repeat that part.
This is the thing.
Let's say
very easy to understand, right? I hope so, you understand me now. Let's talk about this
these representational pawn images that are identical to power pieces images. Let's give them proper name. So, the kings, here is a king, king image, and a king's pawn. This is his proper name, right? King's pawn. Queen and a queen's pawn. Even rook, even pawn. So this even pawns belongs to this rook. Like if you would play chess, that if it stands on white square, this one will stand in front of it on a black square, right? If you play chess for two and you have this stands on the other side of the board, his pawn will stand in front of it. And that's how it's called in chess, right? Like rook's pawn or odd number dot or odd number horse or the horse which stands on the black square. The other one is even number and he's standing on the other side. I'm talking about chess for two, right? He's standing on the other side on a white square, right? So it's like white bishop and a black bishop, right? So that would be odd and even. But the name of their pawns would be like, bishop's pawn, right? Even bishop's pawn, odd horse pawn, king's pawn, odd number, rook pawn, even number horse pawn, and so on. I mean, I'm just bothering you. I know you understand, all understand that. But this is, then people ask me, but why do you have pawns on a chess pieces, on a cubes? But the cubes are here, there are 64 of them, and they can be divided in two sets, right? One set would be power pieces, the other pawns, right? But they could be two sets of chess pieces for two, right? I mean, for two players, right? And that's the whole story. That's why they exist. Because they're used for chess for two, 32 in each set, or for chess for four, as 64 position, as I show you here. And there would be a story about the color combination, their color combination, their, this is their names, right? King's pawn, but it also has a numerical value, it also has a letter value, it also has a hexagram value. I mean, each cube, each value of this, it has a hexagram value as well, you know? And so all this would be talked about later, but all that exists over here on Tablets of Destinies. It's marked over here. I put it all the values and all the things. Takes a lot of time, I mean. And also the puzzles and things like that, like this puzzle over here on board number two. You see how to position all letters and numbers inside 36 positions and while going from A to Z, right? And also from 0 to 9, right? And you cannot jump square. You have to go from, like, you see A, B, C, D, you see, and then you have to go to E. You cannot jump over the square. You must be close to the letter in order to reach it. And E, F, and so on, you know. They're all marked here. I didn't want to go F, H, I mean G, H, and all this stuff, you know. And then from H to I, and there is everything is marked here and everything is correct, you know. But as I say, I'm going to bother you too much. Just show you some of the options. I'm kind of without breath for some reason. I don't know why. Anyway, this is it. And you see, here is the west side. Here is the north point, north side of the place as well. And a red side, you know. And here we have a yellow point, yellow side, like, you know. And also we have a green point here and a green side of the space. So when you look at the board, anywhere you live in the world, there is always four cardinal points. And you have to position a board according to four cardinal points. And this is it. This one is positioned as it. And any other board in the world that you use, please position it four cardinal points. And then make a setup. And then check up. And then play the game. And then do the rest. When I previously said, trust me, I meant trust me, but verify. Do the same as I do. I trust and verify. So, I'm asking you to listen here, because we are going to verify something. First of all, let's verify the diagonals. Diagonals, blue, yellow diagonal is white diagonal. Green, red is a black diagonal. Here I have a board of original design, my design. But that's not important. It's important is that I tried here to use as least material as possible. So instead of dark or black square being filled with the black color, I marked them with a line, and they are functionally equivalent. So I use, because this is max zilch, maximum nothing, right? So let's try as close as possible. Eliminate color, eliminate expense of filling up this empty, stupid black squares with the black color. Have them with the line. And that part is important, which it saves money. Not that I made it. Okay, the other thing is, as I said, blue, yellow is white diagonal. This is red diagonal. This is red, green, and they are black diagonal. You see? Absent of line means white square. Line means black square. Okay, so now that we know that, why diagonal? Because on diagonal, in a chess for four, always king or queen stands. In this case, queen. In this setup is a queen that stands on diagonal. So there are two white queens and white queens and two black queens. Black queen stands on black diagonal. There are other things too. Have in mind, there are two ways to look at the board.
One way would be inside out, and the other is outside in, which would mean from the center toward the corners, or from the corners toward the center. That would be outside in. From outside in, Queen on a black diagonal is standing to the right of the king, exactly as the rule of chess says. And on a white diagonal, Queen is standing, we are looking from outside in, from the corner toward the center. Queen is standing to the left of the king on a white square. That's the rule in chess. White queen stands to the left of king on a white square, right? Okay, so that's here we also have on each board, black diagonal, same as here. Red, white diagonal, and here's red and green, white, red and green, black diagonal, right? And blue and yellow, blue and yellow, white diagonal. On the other board, blue and yellow, white diagonal, red and green, black diagonal. White diagonal, black diagonal. Black diagonal. And here is the white diagonal, right? And I have, okay, to show you the board number two. You see the black diagonal, so, and a white diagonal, right? Okay, so all of the Tablet of Destinies are positioned in such a way so that coordinate points are always at the same position as they are. So is this board that I'm showing you here. And now we see here that this is, trust me, everything correctly positioned. And why I say so? Because I checked it out. There are no two same sign in the same line. Vertically, horizontally, or diagonally. You will not find in the same line two same sign. And that's the rule for setting up color-coded chess for four players. I will continue later. Now I am again out of breath. Don't know how far I will come with story, but in previous video, I demonstrate, actually explained that there are 24 different combination of this four positions. This four positions, right? Pounds. Those pounds, 24 different. And for each of this combination of four different values, there are 8 different combinations. There are 8 different variations. And in the variation, these position change in between, but these here remain the same, right? So there are 8 of them, 24, and for each of this 24 times 8, there is a color combination, how the group can be positioned, in which corner the group can be positioned, right? There is 12 of them that are
according to the rules, in which we can clearly see here that the red corner doesn't go at all. It's not in line with the green corner, right? Red corner here. Red corner because this is red board corner. This is the red square corner. So the all group are standing on red corners, right? Okay. This one yellow, this one blue, and this on green, right? So this is one, it makes one color combination. There are 12 of them that are legal, in which groups are not in a same line vertically, nor, as you can see here, horizontally. Because, as you can see, red is not in same line with yellow, right? Horizontally. And this red here, right corner, is not in the same line with green corners that are blue group set. All cubes in a group set, right? So that's another color combination. And there are 12 of those such. So 24 times 8 times 12. I know I'm boring, but that's how it goes with me. If you don't like it, go somewhere else. What can I tell you? I'm sorry, but that's how it goes. And then that is about 24. But for the king, while queen is on diagonal, standing, all four queens remain on the same spot. But the kings can change position and still be this still can be a black queen, because the king is also here on the left side. I mean, the queen is also here on the right side from the king. If king goes here from the corner, up, queen is on the right side. Where are you? Here. So let me go to king. King here. That's one of the possibility. But there is also, as I mentioned, two ways of looking at setup. Outside, in, toward the center, and from the center toward the corner, or inside out. So this would be queen on the right side from outside in. But if I put this king over here, and look from the center outside, then queen is again on a black square to the right of the king, right? And that's one thing. And then this was one. And then another one would be here. If king is here, here, and we are looking from the inside out, king is again, I mean, queen is again to the right of the king on a black square. Black squares, right? Squares with the lines. So let's put the king back. That's how it goes, right? And any time the king changes position, the number doubles. So 24 times 8 times 12, the king changes the previous number plus this total equal the previous total, plus here same total, plus here same total, right? So it's like a fourth time for queen standing on the same spot. But as I mentioned, there are two ways that king and queen can stand. King can also stand on a on a diagonal line, and queen can be to the left looking from outside. Queen is to the left of the king on a white square. So it's a legal setup, right? By changing the queen's position, we have to change the position of their pawns, like king and queen, right? That was, and now the setup is absolutely correct in this group. I have to do same thing in these other groups, and that's how you look. And anytime you change king's and queen's position on diagonal, then the same number that king made, that queen made standing here, now the king can make the same number, which I don't want to repeat, you heard me. Pay attention here. 100 black and white squares of the chessboard divided in four quadrants. Each quadrant of 25 squares. At the corner of each quadrant is marked with color. At the top right corner, it's marked with the blue color. Top left corner with the red color. Bottom left corner with the yellow. And bottom right corner with the green. So, if it is marked with the green, it would be green quadrant. Inside the blue quadrant, all chess cubes are turned into the same direction. And direction that they are turned to, it's a cardinal direction. It's the direction of the north. At the west, or a red point, top left, all the cubes are turned to the west. At the yellow quadrant, they're turned to the south. At the green quadrant, all cubes are turned to the east. Have that in mind. Now, with confidence, we can say that we know every color of any of 64 cubes on a top image of 64 cubes, because we know that direction that the cube is turned, the top of the cube is turned, the top of the image is turned to, would be equal to the color of that cube. We see in the green section, in green quadrant, all 16 cubes are turned to the west, to the blue, to the red color of the west. So each of these 16 cubes would be red at the top. At the blue quadrant, all 16 are turned to the east direction, which is green, right? And they are standing on a green corner, because each individual square is also has four cardinal points: east, west, north, and south. So, just by seeing the way they are turned, in which direction, we know their colors. Now that we see in which direction each group is turned, we know the color of each color of the top on each cube. By knowing that this group is turned to the west, all in the group are turned to the west, and they are all red, because the red is the west. But now we know that, now that we know all these invisible colors, we would like, in each group, we would like to know, also know, what is the four invisible four color combination for each of the cube, a top image on the top of the cube. And that part I will show you next video or one of the next. So let's resume one more time, you know. We know, we see direction of the group, we know the color, invisible color on the top of each of the cube, of the image on the cube. And we want to know, all right, we know that color, this one would all would be an invisible red because we all see black in front of us. But invisible red is coming from the red side, from the red corner, from the west side. So, and now we want to know what is the four color combination for each of top of 64 cubes. So we know the color of the top, invisible color of the top. We want to know is it invisible four color combination. And I will be thinking about it, how to present to you in one of next, maybe next or, you know, I don't know. We'll see.
But before I set up all four quadrants, same way the red quadrant is already set up, I have another surprise for you. If you remove colors at four corner, then the remember one thing. At the top of the board, of the image, is always north. At the left is west. At the right, excuse me, at the left is west. At the right is east. At the bottom is south. So, unless on board four corners are marked with the four colors, then we will read as they are marked. Let's say if they're marked, let's say this way, then we will read differently, right? Then we will read exactly as it is here. Right, north, blue corner, at the top right, at the top left, red corner, at the bottom left, yellow corner, at the bottom right, green corner. Green corner means side at the right of the image is east, left is west, bottom south, top north. Because that is how it's marked. But if there is no marking, if you take my advice and remove four color, then besides removing black from the black squares, you also remove four colors from four corner. But nevertheless, you still know which side is north, which side is south, which side is left, which side is right, because there is a rule which says if there is no four color at the four corner, top of the image represent north, bottom, south, left, west and right, east. Ciao. In each of four quadrant, we see four cubes. Turn to the left, four to the right, four up, four down. Which means 16 are turned to the left, 16 to the right, 16 north or to the up and 16 south to the down. Left is west, right is east. each quadrant, 4 cubes each direction. No two same sign going same line, vertically, horizontally, or diagonally. You can stop the video and verify what I'm saying. But it's basically you can stop now and check it out, blow up and verify. Different people understand differently. This is why this is presented now this way. So here we see first two. These two are even value cubes. These two are odd value cubes. We have first one represents 16 cubes, even value cubes, that are pounds. And this one are 16, represents 16 cubes that are even value power pieces on them. There is 6 images on 6 sides of this 4 times 16 cubes, which mean on 64 cubes there is 6 sides, and on each side there is a different image. Here we are going to see images on all 6 sides, and we are going to, I'm going to move one by one. That's one. The next one, sorry, the next one is this one. So what we see here, we see horse and we see horse pound. We see odd value horse and we see odd value horse pound here. What we see here, even value bishop's pound. Even value bishop, odd value bishop's pound, odd value bishop, value 2, value 3, value 3, value 2. Let's go further. We have to see rooks. So we are here, we go here twice, once, twice, once, twice, once, twice. So we see even value rooks pound, even value rook, odd value rook's pound, odd value rook. Right? So far we have seen 4 characters. Now on odd value cubes we see queen. And at even value cubes we see queen. Right? So far, we have seen 5 sides And these five sides are used for four color chess. Right? Pawns are not used. 64 pawns exist as well on these 64 cubes, and they are here. Right? This one represents 16. Look exactly the same. Same size, same direction. 16, 16, 16. As a matter of fact, all 64 look, as you have seen, exactly the same. The only difference is odd value cubes have dots on them, on images that have their odd values. And even value cubes don't have dots because they don't have odd values on them. The only odd value that they have on them is a king, right? And king has a dot. All on all 64 cubes, kings have a dot because it has odd value. And queen on all 64 cubes don't have any dot, right? Because it is even value. Number 8, king is 9, rook odd, rook is number 7, even value rook is number 6, so is his pawn, and horse odd value has value of 5, and it's marked with number 1, right? And bishop 0 is bishop odd, bishop is marked with 0, and odd rook is marked with capital A, vowel, right? And about that, that is a science. That is a science that are complements to the values. That is the name of chess pieces. That is K stands for king, capital K, for Q as well. For horses, capital H, for bishop, capital B, for rook is capital R, right? And so on. And about that, there is a video coming. And if you look at the Tablet of Destinies, they talk about it. They give every values and all complements. And you can find it, Tablet of Destiny number 1 and Tablet of Destiny number 6 specifically about that. Bye-bye for now.
Most valuable images or most valuable chess pieces of king, queen, odd with dot and even rook have in each of four groups. Together with them, three other chess pieces that are turned same directions as there are in their own groups, in their own quadrants. So king, horse, odd rook, pawn, and bishop's pawn makes one of those four turn same direction in this group. In this group, we see four same direction. If you check for queens and bishop, odd bishops and even bishop, we will see all of them have three other turn same direction as they are king, queen, odd with dot, rook, and even rook. They all have three other, let's say even rook, three other turn same direction as they are. Even rook turn same direction as even rook, three others. And here, even rook turn same direction as three others. And those for even rook, three others, are always the same images in all four groups. That is to say that we have 16 chess pieces turn each of four directions in all four groups together. In each we have a four turn each direction. For here each direction, for here each direction, for here each direction, together 16 to four cardinal points. I want to say something else about cardinal points. They are here, north, south, west, and east. Therefore, north side is here. Therefore, west side is here. Therefore, south side is here. Therefore, east side is here, this side. But if we change, if we say, no, north is here, then you see here, if we look here for north,
we can see that odd rooks group of four are turned to the east direction, right? If the north side is here, but if the north side is here, let me move the blue point over here. Give me a second. So blue point is here, red is here, yellow is here, and green side is here, right? So look, now we have a blue, north is here, south is here, west is here, and east is at the right side. If north is here, south is down, to the left is west, right? But if we go to the blue point here, back, if this is a cardinal point of the north, right? South, west, east. We have seen that this one is in a group with odd value rook. Four of them are turned to the east, which was here, because here is the cardinal point east. And green from here was here, right? Green, green, right? Let's put it back here. Okay, so, but we can see now, if the north is here, the same chess piece is turned to the south, because north is here. In order to properly know what is this invisible color that exists on this black 64 chess pieces, each one has invisible color on them. Now we can see that the invisible color is yellow for the same chess piece, because north is here. But when the north was here, when the north was here, right? North was here, then this was, this same chess piece was turned to the east, right? So, remember all this. I will continue with the story. When 64 cubes are positioned at the center of each of 64 squares, as now, then there is a problem on diagonals, because as you can see, two same signs appears on diagonal, right? On black diagonal, there are same signs. On white diagonal, there are same signs. Like two queens. Queens also problem have vertically and horizontally. So, how do we avoid all this problem? We avoid, as I have shown in two previous videos, with four corners. Right? And now you can look back the other video and you will see solution. Here, it's against the rule. You cannot have two same images in the same line, horizontally, vertically, or diagonally. But as far as this image shows, we have exactly that here. So this is not legal setup.
I'm only showing you why we are playing corners. Why each chess piece has to be at a corner position. That way, there will never be two colors in the same line, horizontally, vertically, or diagonally, as you have seen in previous video. Right? I'm standing here just to allow you to see. You see? Otherwise, they are not the same sign, horizontally or vertically, in the same line. Here. But diagonally, there is a problem. Also, queen has horizontally and vertically problem. No other but the queen. Or, if on that position is a king position instead of queen, and the queen goes on a position of king. And their pawns also exchange positions, and that would be legal. Right? But then the king would be diagonally, two same kings in the same line, diagonally. Not allowed, right? So we use corners. Enough. It's enough.